changes around the world. The whole world faces a challenge with the production of energy, because most of our sources is based on oil, petrol, and natural gas, which is harmful and non-permanent. Imagine if you have 100 gallons of petrol after a specific time, this amount will run out. You will have no source to produce electricity anymore. But there is still a hope. In the recent time, the whole world started to generate electricity by the solar power, because it's permanent, renewable, and the most important part is for free. Hold on, there is nothing for free. I'll prove to you. Two techniques to generate electricity by the solar power: photovoltaic and concentrated solar power, CSP. So let's focus on concentrated solar power, which has a high efficiency. The most important types of CSP is parabolic trough, power tower, linear Fresnel, and dish in jar. Let's have more focus on the dish in jar technology, which is based on a dish covered shape supported with a mirror. This mirror collects the sun heat and reflects it in one point to generate a renewable way for electricity. Now, this project is based on some hypotheses. For example, the sunlight must be perpendicular with 90 degrees to get the highest efficiency. So, what if it wasn't 90 degrees? If it wasn't 90 degrees, it will produce a less efficiency. So, this project will be supported with a solar tracker, which will detect the sun slope and move the dish in jar according to it to have the 90 degrees and the highest efficiency. The dish in jar will turn the sun all day. When the sun is reflected to the dish in jar, the curved tube will send most of its power to a receiver. The receiver tube is filled with a fluid. This fluid is responsible about heat of the water in a heat exchanger. A turbine spins a generator which produces the electricity in the end. Then the water is turned into a steam, and this steam is sent off to a turbine. The turbine will spin the generator which produces the electricity in the end. But here is the good part. Once the fluid transfers its heat, it recycles and used over and over like the closed cycle. And the steam is also cooled, condensed, and recycled again. One more thing, the heat liquid can be stored and used later when the sun isn't shining. Actually, there are three variables for this project. First, the independent variable, which is the sunlight. Second, the dependent variable, which is the vapor pressure. Third, the constant variable, which is the amount of the liquid. I'm assuming this liquid is water? Exactly, because the water has a suitable and low boiling point. This is the engineering drawing. Let me show you the steps of building prototype for this project. The first method is to use a dish curved chain and a broken mirrors to recycle it. Second one is to stick the mirrors on the curved chain. The trick here to increase the efficiency of the prototype that the real solution will be based on a one piece of mirror, but the prototype will be based on lots of pieces of mirrors that will be defined. The trick part here to increase the efficiency that the real solution will be based on a one piece of mirror, but the prototype will be based on lots of broken pieces of the defined mirrors. This technique will collect more heat of the sun. The next step is to bring an old metal box and put a specific amount of water in it. The next step is to bring an old metal box and put a specific amount of water in it. The position of this metal box will be in the focus of the mirrors. The evaporated water will move the turbine that will spin the generator, and boom, you have electricity. The single dish in jar will produce a 25 kilowatt of power. And the single turret can produce a 250 megawatt. Whoa, that's enough to power 90,000 homes! Finally, this project is based on collecting the sun heat reflected in one focus, send it to the power system, and boom, you have a new renewable source to produce electricity. This project will solve the challenge of producing electricity and affect positively on the economy. Thank you for listening. This was Rina Song.